Toby Fox released Undertale in 2005. It surprised everyone, even him, with the success it garnered, with many people asking Toby Fox when and what his next game was going to be. Recently, we had that question answered with the free download of DeltaRune, a beta/proof of concept from Toby Fox. You'll find the download in the description below, and I encourage you to play it, but this video shouldn't spoil anything for you. However, there are going to be some Undertale spoilers. So DeltaRune, this 2-hour free game, was essentially Toby's first chapter in the game he hasn't even started to make yet. It's a demo, like the one Undertale had. I haven't made a video in a while, so I'm just gonna toss this real quick essay out. Consider it a hot take. I don't think that DeltaRune will be very good, and I'm referring to the chapters he hasn't made yet. And I think this for a few reasons. Number one, the on-rails nature of the game. By the way, as confirmed by Toby Fox on a Twitter blog post. And two, the new but samey battle system. The battle system in DeltaRune is a lot like the system in Undertale, a turn-based RPG with bullet hell mechanics that allow you to dodge enemy attacks, which was a fun idea for the first game, but it's always been true that the arrow key control has always felt very clunky for a bullet hell mechanic. And none of that has changed in DeltaRune. I will say what is new though is in Undertale, you play as one person. In DeltaRune, you play as a party of people, with caster, damage, and balance as your team build. But arguably, the center mechanic in Undertale was the ACT ability, which allowed you to non-violently avoid combat situations. But you also had the choice to attack your enemies as well in Undertale. That choice to whether or not act or fight had major consequences in the gameplay and story of Undertale. In DeltaRune, you're also able to act, but it doesn't really do anything besides affect the way NPCs act to you. It doesn't change the story in any palpable way. Which brings us to the main reason I think DeltaRune will be mediocre. It's going to be a story on rails, with no multiple endings, regardless of your actions. Which was why Undertale was so well received. Mind you, it wasn't its only virtue, but it was the biggest and most interesting aspect to the game. Never mind the characters, they were corny and memorable, but only memorable, in large part, because of how the player interacted with them. You could harm or befriend them, and they and other NPCs would respond to the player's actions. You could befriend Papyrus, and he'd have to tell you about his sad life, or you could kill him in cold blood, and his brother would come after you for revenge. That level of connection is nearly gone in a linear game, where a player can't express themselves through a character. When nothing really happens, whether you use damage or acting to get past foes, the commentary on violence being often the only tool in video games is completely gone at that point, and all we're left is just another Earthboundian indie game with a cult following. I'm not sure if Toby Fox's writing or kinda new combat system will be good enough to make DeltaRune rise above Undertale, or even match it. In short, I don't think the combat system will be much better than Undertale, which is to say mediocre. And I don't know how the story is going to be as good or better. So when the rest of it comes out, expect my expectations for DeltaRune to be tempered. And that all being said, I really loved Undertale, and I hope Toby Fox can make another game that is good or better. Maybe this game will be about the lack of choices in gaming, which looks like what it might be. But at the end of the day, I want DeltaRune to be good as Undertale, if not better. I'm just not sure if that'll be the case.